Hi everyone, welcome to my online channel. Today I am going to discuss engine room mathematics. So this engine room mathematics is referring to mathematics applied or applying to the ship. So I encourage those who are aspiring for officers, especially aspiring for ship engineer. So if you are a student, you are a new engineer, you are a fourth engineer, third engineer, second engineer, and especially you are aspiring to become a chief engineer. So this engine room mathematics is used for calculation, reporting, because every company, every charterer, they require abstract, so we have abstract. So we use engine room mathematics. So to start with, we have here the problem. So fuel consumption per voyage distance. So how much fuel to be consumed to cover the distance of 7,000 miles. So this is required for ship engineers, third engineers, or sometimes second engineers, but mostly ship engineers. And sometimes the ship engineers assigned to third engineers. So here, the requirements is how much fuel to be consumed to cover the distance of 7,000 miles. So we don't touch this area. I prepare here for calculation. So we have here the data. So given data. So here we have 7,000 miles, and the data of the engine we have here 680 millimeter, the bore of the engine, engine cylinder, and we have here the length of stroke 1,250 millimeter, and we have here the number of cylinders is 6 cylinders. We have the mechanical efficiency, which is 85%, and we have the mean effective pressure, which is 8.5 kilogram per square centimeter, and we have the RPM, which is revolution per minute of the engine. We have the pitch 3.15 meter, and we have the specific fuel consumption, which is 156 grams brake horsepower per hour. So this data is, so from here to here is taken from your instruction manual, your book. Book of your engine, of your main engine, and here we have the fuel oil specific gravity at 15, which is 0.9700, and your heating of your fuel is EPO heating temperature is 85. So this is only example. Normally our heating over EPO is 125 to 135 degrees Celsius. Propeller slip is 5%. So it's like your engine, your ship engine is running in, for example, in 100%. And since you have 5% slip, so 100 minus 5 is 95%. So this is your slip. So your engine, your ship is working only 95% because you have propeller slip, which is 5%. So now we have to calculate. So in calculating the first, you have to calculate the cylinder constant. So the formula of the cylinder constant is length times the area multiplied by the length of stroke. So now, so over 4,500. So this unit, this formula is for metric. So we have metric. Metric units, and we have English, or English units. So if this is English units, this is over 33,000. But this is metric units, so we solve in metric, so this is 4,500. So now, let us calculate. So, let us substitute the value. So first here, calculating your length of stroke, we have here 1,250 millimeters. So we have to convert it into meter. So you have to divide this one into 1,000 because 1 meter here. So 1 meter is equal to 1,000 millimeter. So you have to convert into meter. So now is one decimal 2.5 meter. So let us continue. So I will erase this one so that I can write here. So now we also convert the value for the area. So since we have here the 680 millimeter, we have to convert it into centimeter. So 1 centimeter, so I will show you. So instead of using calculator, I will use the Excel to substitute the calculator. So more easy, for me more easy. So I will calculate 60 mm. So divide by 100. That is wrong. So 6 divide by 10. So 68. So meaning one centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So we divide 680 into 10 millimeter. So our result is 68 centimeter. So here, 68 centimeter. So here's this one. Now, since we are calculating the area, lead times, so we substitute here. So area, the formula of the area is, so here, area is, so this one, I will show you here. So I will use this one here. So formula of the area is pi diameter square over or divide or. So we substitute here, we substitute here, so 3.1416, the value of pi, multiplied by 68, so we have to square 68, divide by 4. So, if you calculate that one, so I will use Excel instead of using calculator because it is really easy for me. So, we are substituting the value. So length, so here, 1.25. So length to stop. So we calculate that the area here. So if you if you multiply 68 times 68, so this one, this will give you 4,624. So 68. So I will show you. 68 multiplied by 68. So it's not working here. So 68. Why is not working? So anyway, now it's working. So 68. It's not working. Anyway, I already calculated here. So this is the 68 multiplied by 68. So that is the result. And then your value of your pi is 3.1416. 14.16 divided by 4. So this is the result. 0 decimal 78 by 4. So 3.14.16, the value of your pi divided by 4. So this is the result. So here we have to calculate. So your area 4624 multiplied by 0 decimal 7854. So this will give you a result 3631 decimal 690. So you have to substitute in here. So 125 multiplied by your area. So let to stop times your area divided by 4500. So this is your result. So as you can see here, I multiply 125 to length of stroke divided by 4500. So this is the result. So this is your cylinder constant. This one. This is your cylinder constant. So I will erase this one. So so now we already solved the cylinder constant. So next to solve is your propeller distance. So your pitch, so in solving the propeller distance you have to substitute your pitch here, and then since this is meter, we have to convert it into feet. So 1 foot, no, 1 meter is equivalent to, so this is your conversion here. So I will write here. So here 1 meter is equivalent to 3.3 decimal 28 feet. So we have to convert. So 3 decimal 15 multiplied. So we have to multiply. There is by the way, I forgot to write the just listen to my explanation. So we have to multiply here 3.28 over 1. So we have to cancel this unit meter, and here you have to cancel meter, and then the result is 10.33 feet. Then we have to divide with the 6080 feet per miles. So if you recalculate that one, we arrive in this. So I divide 10 decimal 33 divided by 6080 feet per miles. Then I got the result here. So we can cancel the feet in here, feet and feet. So the remaining is miles. So propeller distance is 0.00169934 miles. So next, so I use this one. Yes, this one. So let us proceed here. So we already solved the cylinder constant and the propeller distance. So I already solved this using the Excel. I just explained here so that you can have the idea. So this this is in general mathematics applied to the ship. So this is used for reporting. So reporting to company, reporting to others. So next, we will solve the brake horsepower. Brake horsepower. So using all of this data. So brake horsepower. So by the way, and we will continue. So in solving the brake horsepower, we have here the formula: cylinder constant multiplied by the RPM, multiplied by the mean effective pressure, multiplied by the mechanical efficiency, and multiplied by number of cylinders divided by 100. So here, so here multiplied and divide. So multiply and divide. So we will now substitute the values. Substitute the given data. So your cylinder constant is this one. So we substitute the value of cylinder constant. So this one decimal 0088. We substitute the RPM 140. We substitute the mean effective pressure 8.5. We substitute the mechanical efficiency 85%, and we substitute the number of cylinders divided by 100. So that one. So this is the result. So divide by 100. So if we so the result, all of this data is, so we multiply all of this. The result is 612,242 decimal 3384. So divide by 100 is, the result is 6,122 horsepower. So we already now solved the brake horsepower. So here is the consumption. So this is only for my reference, but the problem is here. the solution of the problem. So let us continue. We will solve now the fuel oil consumption per hour. So we substitute now the horsepower. So here, so I substitute the 6,000. So the formula here is the brake horsepower So the brake horsepower multiplied by your consumption. So I will show you. So your consumption. So we multiply that one. So if you multiply that one, so brake horsepower multiplied by your fuel oil consumption in grams BHP per hour. So if you trace that value here, your EPO consumption in grams brake horsepower hour. So here, you can cancel the horsepower. So this is horsepower, and here is horsepower. So you have to cancel that one. So your consumption is 955,098 grams brake horsepower per hour. So since you need metric tons per hour, so in 1 metric tons is equal to 1,000,000 grams. So I will write here your the conversion. So this is your conversion. 1 metric tons is equal to 1,000,000 grams. So grams, so 1,000,000 grams. So you have to divide this value to 1,000,000. So now the result is 0.95510 metric tons per hour. So that is your consumption. So next, so I will erase this one. Save. So next to calculate is your propeller distance per minute. So you have already here the propeller distance. This is your propeller distance. This one. So propeller distance per minute. So here we have to substitute the value. So how many miles? So here we will trace your propeller distance. So this is your propeller distance. So your propeller distance, you have to multiply by 140. So RPM, 140 RPM, since your RPM here is 140. Here, this is your 140. This is your RPM. So you have to multiply to 140. So your propeller distance multiplied by 140 RPM. So the result is, so this one, 0.23791 miles, because you cancel minute. So the remaining is miles. So your propeller distance per minute is 0.23791 miles. Then you have to convert it into hour. So multiply these miles, multiply by 60 minutes, then you got 14.27 your propeller distance per hour or in an hour. Next, since your propeller slip is 5%, so your ship engine is working supposedly 100%, but since you have propeller slip 5%, then you have to minus 100 minus 5%. We have here 95 or 0.95, because this is deducted with your 5% slip. Then if you multiply your 14.27 by 0.95, this will give you 13.56 miles per hour. So that is your propeller distance per hour applied with a 5% slip. So 100% minus 5% is 95%. So this is here you multiply 0.95. So this is your propeller distance. So since your distance to travel is 7,000 miles, so here, as you can see here in the problem, you have to travel 7,000 miles. So we will apply divide your 7,000 miles into 13.56 miles, your propeller distance. So this will give you your total consumption in metric tons, 0.95510 metric tons. submitted as so this is in
per hour this consumption. If you multiply it into 24 hours,
so so here, our ECO consumption is zero decimal, or our ECO consumption per hour is 0.95510 metric tons per hour. So we have to substitute here, and we have to multiply your number of hours in cubic miles. So 516 decimal 20 multiplied. So this will here. So multiplied by so 0.95510 multiplied by 516.20. This will give you 493.002 metric tons. Metric tons. Fuel oil, total fuel oil consumption in 7 miles to cover the distance of 7 miles. 7 miles distance. So that is how to calculate the consumption, the total consumption to cover the distance of 7 miles. So I suggest to if you study this video to pause the video and take down notes and analyze. So this is in general mathematics applied for the ship. So I have another video. Please subscribe to my channel and click the notification button so that you will be updated on my next video. I will prepare a lot of in general mathematics. So forward. Those who are aspiring for to become chief engineer, you can follow this video tutorial. Thank you for watching and see you on my next video.